Привіт, it's me with you, Taya from Ukraine, and welcome to my channel again. Today, guys, I will teach you how to use public transport in Ukraine, which is super, super easy. But the only thing that you might face with is language barrier. So, subway. In Kyiv, subway is number one transport in the whole city. You can actually survive without a car, so you have to learn how to use subway. There are three lines, not billions like in China or France, so you can learn them. When you go into the subway, you see the line usually of people who want to buy tokens. So these round things, yes, we use them. Tokens, it costs right now 8 hryvnia, but maybe in 1 year it will cost more. I can't predict it. It let you to go to any other direction you need. You can be in the subway how much time you want. No limits about that. However, you cannot buy a lot of tokens in the same time. So I think maximum 2, because they want to motivate you to use card. Also, you can see the machine, they usually are orange, and you can put their money and it will give you a change. Now we have 1 and 2 Ukrainian hryvnia, which is not by bills, you know, paper money, but by coins, and a lot of people hate it. You can buy such green card, I have a 2, where you can put 50 travels. It even makes you a discount. It's very small, but still. I advise it to do with a woman, because you can do it in machine, but machine doesn't give you change, and plus you might be confused. So you can buy this card. It cost around 15 maybe Ukrainian currency, and when you don't need it, you can just give it to her back. And you can use it unlimited amount of time, but I'm not sure if it will work after 1 year if you don't use it. Or when you go inside already the subway station, so you need to pass these things, and you see the yellow one, you can use with a card. So you can take your MasterCard or Visa, and be careful. You always need to understand on which way you have to go, left or right, because those trains are coming in different direction. Put your eyes above and see, it will be written which way is for you. In Europe, what I find different is you cannot change your direction. In Ukraine, it's very easy. I don't know, you fell asleep, you can change your direction, you forgot, your plans are changed. But in Europe, I felt a bit lost about that, because you see, you're waiting for your train, and you see people on other side of the subway, so between you there are trains. Usually it's vice versa. The platform here and subway are on this sides. Actually, it's very noisy, and I would advise you to take something, to grab something, so you will not fall, because sometimes the driver is crazy and it can stop any second. Also, pay attention when you go out of the subway, of the train itself. You also take care about your route, because it can be right or left, depends on the station. You have to look at the streets, either ask someone, because sometimes it's even for me too, I'm too confused, I don't know. Another public transport will be tram. A tram usually is used in only few districts in city center and on the left bank. You can buy tickets directly in the old lady who is a conductor, who can, I mean, we call her conductor, who can give you the ticket, and you need to compose it, right? You know, this old school machine. Bus is more modern. I advise you to use bus, because it should tell you the station, so you will not be lost. Again, you can buy tickets at the lady. And marshrutka, which everyone hates, is a small bus. It's a super duper exclusive of Ukraine. You can buy tickets at the driver. My foreigners always laugh, like when the marshrutka is full and you're sitting near the driver, you need to pass money all the time, because that's how it works, especially in evening and morning when everyone goes from job and to job, to work. In subway they use English, they tell you stations, so you shouldn't be worried and lost about that. However, about others, I have doubts, because I usually also use Google Maps. I know just few routes which I have to know. Metro exists in other cities like Kharkiv, and it also exists in Dnipro, but it's only few subway station. Everyone uses tram, and they built 20 years one line. And just buy SIM card, because internet will always help you. Wi-Fi is not on all the subway stations. I don't recommend to rely on it. Usually the connection disappears when you're underground of subway. Most of our subway is underground, so, and very deep. Everyone is confused why it's so deep, because it was built during Soviet time. Thank you for watching my video. Let me know about your questions. Give thumbs ups and comments. That the way you can help me developing and widespread my videos. And see you the next time. Bye.